All aboard. Here we go. We could call it ascension. But the real way to ascend is to practice getting familiar in the following way. To practice familiarity, no realization, no realizer, nothing to realize. No realization, no realizer, and nothing to realize. No attainment, no attainer, and nothing to attain. So as we go up, symbolizing ascension, no ascension, no ascender, nowhere to ascend to. Neither ascension nor ascension. Neither ascension nor ascension. Now this is something we're not familiar with at all, to look at it in this way. No arrival, no arrivee, nowhere to arrive to. So no attainment, no attainer, nothing to attain. No realization, no realizer, nothing to realize. No enlightenment. No enlightened one, nothing to be enlightened. Neither ascension nor ascension, nor neither realization nor realization. Neither enlightenment nor enlightenment, neither attainment nor attainment, neither arrival nor arrival. Now, in practicing like this, the mind will feel a bit jittery. Of course, this is the wow reaction. Just as we're going up here, we're feeling this wow reaction on this ride, this ascension ride. Ascension is the realization that there's no ascension, no ascender, and nothing, nowhere to ascend to. No realization, no realizer, and nothing to realize. And this can be explained by saying that the kingdom of now is just isness. No one reaches the kingdom of now. There's no reaching the kingdom of now. No one reaches the kingdom of now. There's nowhere to reach to. The nowness is the isness. And it cannot be thought of as somewhere to reach to, something to attain, something to be realized. There's no realizer. So, the kingdom of nowness, we're already that. There's only that. We've been pretending that there's something else, and then we think, oh, we're trapped. We need enlightenment. There's no one to be enlightened. There's no enlightenment. No one to be enlightened, and nothing to be enlightened about. No one. But this is something we need to practice, getting familiar with this, because we've been thinking someone needs to be enlightened. No, nobody needs to be enlightened. Someone needs to reach the kingdom of now. The kingdom of now is not reachable. Kingdom of now is not reachable. There's no one to reach it. And there's nothing to reach. Reaching implies somewhere else. So all the implications of enlightenment, realization, reaching, attainment is the implication that there's somewhere else, something else somewhere else, and there isn't. There's only the kingdom of now. It's never been born. It's not born of something else. There's nothing outside of it, trapped, trying to reach it. So as we go on this ascension, it's really the letting go of the idea of ascension. Paradoxical. Paradoxical, but true. We cannot ascend into the now. We cannot reach the now. We cannot grasp the now. We cannot realize the now. There's no one to realize it. There's nothing to realize. There's no realization. The trouble we have is we're waiting for someone to realize the now. There isn't any realization of the now. There's no one to realize it. Nothing to realize. The now is not something that can be realized. It is. It already is. It's always already is. And don't struggle to resolve the paradox, I mean paradox. Just get familiar with this. It brings up a bit of nervousness, somewhat like this ride, saying, wow. We don't need to realize now. We don't need to reach it. We don't need to attain it. We already are that. There's only that. The kingdom of now dawns in that we recognize that there isn't anyone to attain it. There isn't anyone to realize it. No realization is needed. And so the I, the realizer, we let go of that pretense. Through familiarity and letting it go. We've heard it say to surrender, to letting go. Letting go of the false self. The one that we have believed needs to attain, needs to realize, needs to awaken, needs to be enlightened. There's no awakening, no awakener, and nothing to awaken to. Now, we're not saying this intellectually, merely intellectually. It is for the sake of practicing it, hearing it, and feeling it. And there's a sort of a slight disorientation, wow effect in hearing this. This is why it's a practice. Practice really implies here there is some slight disorientation that we have to account for and expect ahead of time. Therefore, that's why practice is done sitting quietly, stillly, because this minimizes the disruption of this slight disorientation, or the shock of. And there's no seeing now. You cannot see now. There's no seer, nothing to be seen. No seeing, no seer, nothing to be seen. No seer. No seeing, no seer, nothing to be seen. No seeing, no seer, nothing to be seen. Similarly, we say no teacher, no teaching, no student. No teacher, no teaching, no student. No seeing, no seer, nothing to be seen. No achievement, no achiever, nothing to achieve. And it is merely by hearing this in a practice mode where the acceptance, the familiarity sinks in. It has to be done in a practice mode, not an intellectual mode. Intellectual mode, you notice in it that they're ready for action. They're committed to action. Whereas practice mode, you're committed to non-action. You're committed to not doing anything. sitting quietly, committed to not taking any action one way or the other. Committed to non-action, you might say. But let's just leave it simple. Committed to not taking any action. And in this state of mind, then it's possible to hear this and to experience the reaction to it, the wow reaction. It's kind of a shock. Well, it is a shock. I'm experiencing the shock right now of doing this. And then you just sit quietly and allow the shock to vaporize, gradually evaporate. Like a bell, hitting a bell and letting the resonance gradually die down. That's the whole secret. We can spend a lifetime intellectually going over this and get nowhere. We have to experience the burn. This is like a burn. Hearing this is like we feel this burn in us, like, wow. This is just so flipping the script so severely. And when we practice like no attainment, neither attainment nor attainment, this really catches the mind off guard, doesn't it? We're expecting some other formulation, but when we say no attainment, neither attainment nor attainment, there's nowhere to go conceptually. We don't need to go anywhere. So we have to practice or nowhere to go. No one to go there and nowhere to go. No achievement, no achiever, nothing to achieve. So this hits us hard, and the burn will feel sort of an aching within and just an intensity like, wow, I don't know what to do about this. No doing, no doer, nothing to do. No doing, no doer, nothing to do. So the whole key is to allow this just to be heard and accepted and sink in and affect us. Be affected by it. Be moved by it. Let it hit hard. And by sitting here quietly like this, we're able to allow it. To allow it in. Allow this in to our mind. We're in this car here, picking this ride, but we're stable, we're quiet, right? We can don't have to move around. Everything seems to be moving around us, but actually, we're standing still, sitting quietly. We can either sit quietly, in this case, we're standing quietly. Commitment to non-action, commitment to not taking any efforts, no action, not doing anything. As we practice, no doing, no doer, nothing to do. No doer, no doing, no doer, nothing to do. No doing, no doer, nothing to do. Keep in mind, this is intentional practice that we're doing. And willful, using the will, intentionally practicing this way. This has to be emphasized over and over. This is where we come up short. We just keep trying to integrate it into our life. Like it's just part of the normal flow of our life. But we have to set aside and make a commitment for a period of time like this to committed to not doing anything. Not trying to achieve, not trying to attain, not this. Only this one focus of familiarity. There's nothing we need to do to make truth true. It's already the case, but we do because of our continuity fear, need to work on familiarity here and acceptance. Getting to the top ultimately symbolizes that we've reached enough familiarity, enough acceptance of the kingdom of now. We're leaving behind all the false notions of attaining the kingdom of now. There is no such thing as attaining the kingdom of now. No attainment of the kingdom of now. No attainer of the kingdom of now. Nothing to attain in the kingdom of now. And we need not integrate this into attaining. Nothing to integrate. No integration, no integrator, nothing to integrate. No integration. No integrator, nothing to integrate. I hope everyone is enjoying the ride. Enjoy the ride. Enjoy the ride. Rarely do you hear a willingness to practice like this, but this is all we have to do. Very simple. No integration, no integrator, nothing to integrate. No realization, no realizer, nothing to realize. Neither realization nor realization. Neither realization nor realization. When we get to the top, we realize there's no realization, no realizer, no arrivee, no arriving. We've always been here. There's only here. There's only here, and we've just been pretending that there's someplace else. So we're taking a pretend ride here. Pretending to arrive, but there's no arrival in everywhere. Where could we arrive from? No arrival, no arriving. Nothing, nowhere to arrive to. No arrival, no arrivee, nowhere to arrive to. Now, we don't have to stay 24 hours a day in this practicing because it brings up quite a shock. We do need to do it every day, though. Keep getting back to it every day. See, we can do that every day. It's like jumping rope. You can jump rope every day. I jumped rope this morning. We can stretch every day. We need to stretch the mind out like this. So, enjoy the kingdom of now. Enjoy the kingdom of now.